Hi, I'm at Wilson Farms, and we are about to AI, which is artificially inseminate a cow. So here comes Mr. Wilson. Are the cows, where are they? There they are. Right there. He's bringing them up, the ones that are ready to get the deed done. See the one? Cows got spooked by us being out close to the road and jumped that fence, and so when he went to get them, we all went back here in these trees behind me to stay out of the way, and except for Wyatt, who went in the barn over there. This is John Wilson of Wilson Farms. He's also the ag teacher at Gainesville High School. He is the, what are you, FFA coordinator, sponsor?
Advisor.
Advisor for the FFA at the school. He's also keeps up to date with politics and policies that affect those kind of things. I always see those kind of posts from you on Facebook. Also a runner and worship leader at church, so. And just a nice guy, friend. So tell us a little bit about what we're going to do tonight with this cow.
We got some cows coming in heat, and so our goal is to breed them through artificial insemination to try to improve our genetics here at our house, and breed in some new bulls into our herd so that we don't have the same bulls breeding over and over again. Maybe we can retain some heifers out of these and build our herd a little better.
All right, and how many head of cattle do you run?
Right now we have 30. I have 30, and my son has some, so.
All right, well, thanks so much for having me. I look forward to this.
You bet, and plug it in and keep it warm. So, there's that. And we have our semen tank. We'll get some semen out here in a minute. Get that ready to go.
So it's on ice.
Liquid nitrogen. This is our AI gun, and these are our protective sleeves that go over them. So
he sounds like a teacher, doesn't he?
That's what I need.
Wyatt, will you warm this up for me while I get this cow ready?
Can you get me a paper towel? It's very high tech.
Is it like this? Oh, wait. How is that?
He needs the...
You don't have to blow on it, but you can rub it and blow on your napkin.
Rough haircuts can
mean. What's you filling on? What did you call it?
Estrogen patch.
So does
Estratech.
It's Estratech.
Estratech.
Is it giving her estrogen or it's monitoring? It changes color according to her cycle or
it was, I got one up here that'll show you.
It was gray whenever we put it on.
Okay.
And then whenever they come in heat. Then they smell it faster than the girls. So whenever they ride, they wear that gray off. You can see the 112 there.
Okay.
The gray.
Gotcha.
Uh-huh. And so whenever it's orange, like mostly orange,
yeah,
it means it's, that they're ready to be bred. If
okay.
it's just a
How do
bit
they
orange,
wear it off? You're saying wear it off. What do you mean?
It's like a lottery
They ride
ticket.
Them.
It's, and it yes. When they ride, rear up and ride the other cows, it scratches it off.
Sorry.
No,
I
thank
didn't know
you.
How else to say it.
Right. No, I need, that's when
they mount the other cows.
Yes.
Because they're in heat and they're showing signs of heat, and if they're standing, then that's what happens if they're standing, because they just keep riding them. They're just standing in heat, letting them ride.
So the girl cows ride the other girl cows.
They will. They sense it, and if they're in heat, sometimes they'll ride another cow too.
Very interesting.
It's just a different sign of estrus cycle. They're ready to be bred.
Squeeze chutes are the bomb.
Definitely,
because if they're not standing well, you squeeze them up a little bit, and they stand like ladies. they make me less nervous.
It catches
oh,
their
head,
awesome.
And then the sides will squeeze up if they're not standing like ladies. Then they'll stand really nice if they get a little pressure on the side, which makes me feel better about working livestock with John.
What?
Right behind that is what we call a palpation. Cage bottom.
So he could be between her and a cow behind her.
Yes.
And you
yes.
could like boom, boom, run them through.
Yes. If that was the case, and you're doing a whole herd that you've synced, then you might would want that. Yes. And it keeps the next gal off of you.
Right. And you would also use this chute at other times for other like vaccinations
yes.
or
yes.
anything like that you need to do.
Yes. Butt boxes to assist with.
Yeah, you need to come like
it's
down here.
To assist with low stress livestock handling. And so when they come in, they are going to look for to go out the same way they come in. That's their natural instinct. So they're going to walk in, and he's going to shut the gate behind them, and then they are going to go back to where they came from. And then when the gate's shut, then they'll go down the alley. There's a lot of things to learn about fight or flight zones with a cow, and just where to put a little pressure on them just by walking up to them, and just some real simple things that you can do that you don't have to make a lot of noise, you don't have to beat them, you don't have to shock them, and it just makes life easier for everybody.
Tell me what you got, Weston.
Shaker paddle.
Tell me about it. What's it for? What does it do?
Get the cows to move.
How? It makes noise.
Pull the gate.
Be perfect.
Pull the gate.
All right, so somebody has a job to collect semen from a bull.
Yes, I bought this. This is a Sim Angus cross semen we're going to be using. Their job is to collect semen. They'll get him to mount, and then they'll catch all the semen as it comes out, and then they put it in little straws and they sell it, and people like me buy it.
They mount what? A machine of some
kind? Sometimes this is a semen straw, and we're going to put it in this water and let it thaw for about 40 seconds. They may have a dummy mount, they may have a steer. Sometimes they just have an electrode that they'll use. But there's all sorts of ways of collecting. And, that is somebody's job at Stratford Reserve, one of the closest places we have, that has a collection site. And I know a lot of college kids have worked there in the past. So. All right, we'll get the semen out.
Is this for Lorella?
No, it's for me. We'll dry it off a little bit, and we'll insert it into this AI gun.
So why AI a cow? Why not just bring in a bull, or own a bull, or?
We own a bull. This is a way to improve genetics. This is a way to get some heifers that we want. It's also a way of having breeding capabilities on this side of our farm without having to worry about the neighbors. That's one of the things. My bull gets next to the neighbor's bull and cause problems, and we don't like that. a lot of torn up fences. You know, his old mangy mutt bull is breeding my old mangy cows. And so, all right, this is a sleeve that goes over your AI gun. It's got a little sponge in the end of it, and that helps to keep the semen from squirting out just real violently once you depress the plunger. So now we're ready to go. Put this in here. Keep it warm, put it next to my hot body, and then we're going to provide her with some lubrication to go in here, and we'll see if we can do this.
All right.
Hello, girl. Clean her vulva just a little bit. The vulva is the external opening of the reproductive tract. She knows we're here. We're going to take the straw for the AI gun. We're going to go ahead and put it in. And insert it until we get some resistance. Then we need to go into the rectum to find the cervix.
What does it feel like?
The cervix feels like a cigar, a garden hose, a big tube of some sort. And hers, actually, wow.
So with your left hand, can you feel the semen gun?
Yes.
So you're guiding it to where the cervix is then?
Yeah.
I feel.
And believe it or not, just like that, we're going to depress slowly and let that semen go in. She's done, just like that.
You did not get a
the goal is, once you find the cervix, you're going to take the gun and go just slightly past the opening to where the uterus starts and the uterine horns, and put your semen at that little opening right there. So, and that's as simple as that. So.
And how long is the gestation period of a cow?
Let's see, 9 months roughly. So.
Similar to human, and the. Yeah. Cycle of a cow is 28 days. Did I hear somebody say that?
Every really? 21 days, I believe it is.
Oh, okay.
So, yeah, we got some. I'd have to look all my stuff in there and see if I can write it down. And look at it. Do you want to feel inside of me?
Sure. I just said sure.
Wish I had them.
Is my arm long enough?
Your arm's going to be fine. Her,
okay.
Her parts are. Fairly close.
All right.
So.
What is this?
That's just an OB glove. It's a slick sleeve.
No, oh, this is like a lube. Lubricant?
OB okay. Lube. So, turn your hand over. We'll get some on the back. This jug's about empty. So. When you go in, you gotta go in like a duck talking or a puppet, okay? Because you know she ain't gonna like that. So go in like this. Tug on her tail a little bit. Let her know you're there, and she's gonna go in. Okay.
Alright.
So, move her tail just a little bit.
Go?
Yep.
That's warm.
Now, below where your hand
you
is.
You reach down?
Well, you can feel. Now, okay. What you're feeling for is like a garden hose. Come back a little bit. You may have been too far.
I don't know. I'm more embarrassed that I can't find it than that I have my hand inside a rump of a cow.
It's okay. It's all right. Let's see.
All right. I feel what feels like a bony structure.
You're looking. This is going to feel just like a surgical tube or something.
There's
like,
something right under the palm of my hand that's like pulsing a little bit. Is that?
Mm-mm.
No.
No, I don't. It's going to. She was about yay long, and she felt like she had a cauliflowered opening about that big around. And you may have been on it at first, maybe.
She walked out. She didn't run out. She didn't jump and buck. So that means she had a good experience.
Oh, gotcha. So she wasn't like, get me out of here now. She's
yes.
Like, okay, we're done.
And it's the same thing whenever we vaccinate them and work them. Then we want them to have a pleasant experience. And therefore, whenever we open them up, they usually just come on out. And we want them to walk out. We don't want them to...
Bye-bye, ladies.